riding out one dark and windy day. Upon a ridge he rested as he went along his way. When all at once a mighty herd of red-eyed cows he saw, a plow through the ragged sky, and up the cloud he brought.
Okay, trade. Thank you.
Thank you. Friends, I am so pleased to announce that the boilers here at the Giant Teapot are full again. That means my special blend will be bubbling up shortly. So if you fancy a nice cuppa, the more the merrier. wise man once said, while there is tea, there is hope. I prefer my hope. Enthusiastic host, Giles Sweetwater. One but would please call me Sweetwater. I would serve you a toast tonight. Still a ways to go for proper tea. One can't rush such things. I need 10 honey, please. Anything less is insufficient.
back, dear listeners. It's time once again to put aside all you think you know, all you believe to be true. Time to open your mind to the strange, bizarre, and sometimes terrifying world that exists in the shadows and fringes of our own, where myth, legend, and rumor are made real. Yes, it's time for more thrilling Tales from the West Virginia Hills. Tonight's episode of Beast of Grafton is brought to you by Dandy Boy Apples. Apples so good, they never go bad. And remember, an apple a day keeps the doctor away. That's Dandy Boy Apples. Fresh, delicious, and dandy every time. Pick up a box today. Our tale begins in the rural hills near Grafton, where locals have reported a strange creature lurking in the woods. Robbie Cockrell and Peggy Mansfield were out on a date, celebrating Peggy's birthday. A full moon loomed large as they drove.
Robbie, you're going too fast.
Don't worry. This nuclear roadster handles like a dream.
Where are you taking me anyway?
I told you, it's a birthday surprise.
Way out here in the woods? There's nothing this far out of Grafton, except that hospital by the river. Wait, I bet we're going to that new drive-in over in Clarksburg, right? Just so you can show off your slick new hot rod.
Ah, come on. Don't be like that, Peggy. I just thought the drive-in would be romantic.
Oh, Robbie.
Time for the thrilling conclusion of The Beast of Grafton.